Notice: our courses are taught in English. If you want to see subtitles in other languages, first, we open the subtitles closed captions at the bottom right of the video. Then click setting and select subtitles CC. And click auto translate. Now you can choose your preferred language from the list. Today we will introduce the easily damaged parts on the S19 hashboard. Let's look at this chip first. It is an ASIC chip. If it is damaged, the hashboard will have low or zero hash rate. Now what we are looking at is a PIC chip. After this chip is damaged, the power supply will not be able to supply power to domain and the ASIC chips in the domain. Now the tweezer is pointing at the memory chip. A damaged memory chip or missing files inside will cause the hashboard to not function properly. TPHR9003N, MOS chip. If the MOS chip is damaged, the voltage output by the power supply will not be able to supply power to the domain and ASIC chip through the MOS tube. Let's take a look at this boost chip. After damage, the boost circuit will have no voltage output, and it will not be able to supply power to the LDO in the last 7 domains. It is a temperature sensor chip. After the chip that is circled now damaged, the control board will not be able to read the temperature of the ASIC chip and PCB board, and the hash board will not operate normally. This chip with 8 pins is a low dropout voltage regulator chip, which will provide 1.8 volt power supply for the domain. PPL 0.8 volt tube. When the chip is damaged, it will affect the signal transmission of the entire hash board. The 5-pin chip here is also an LDO 1.8 volt chip, which is powered by the 14 volt DC voltage input from the power supply. If such chips are damaged, the test fixture will not be able to complete the inspection of the hash board. Well, these are the easily damaged accessories on the S19 hash board, and of course it's not the only ones. Welcome to leave a message.